up, guys? This is James J. Houston Inside Out. I am back with my man, S.A. SOLA. S.A. for San Antonio, repping San Antonio's own SOLA. What's going on, brother? How are you today?
Man, I'm good. So I want to again commend you. We started January with your show, and it set the tone, and we had so many, you know, we got so much to talk about. And then now we're here in December at the end of the year, finishing out the year with things to talk about. Like, I'm excited. Thank you for always being, you know, available to talk to me and check in on me and just somebody that can bounce ideas off of. And, man, thank you. I'm happy to be here.
Yeah, so for people that did not get a chance to look at the other interview, first of all, go look at it, number one. Follow SOLA, Instagram, Facebook. He's got a crazy social media. Very entertaining.
I try.
Girls,
if you're not having fun, why do it, right?
I completely agree with you. I got to do more fun stuff because you inspire me.
Thank you, brother. Thank you, man.
You guys go follow SOLA. I'm going to give out all their information so they can reach you on
absolutely
media. But for people that didn't get a chance to check that first interview, I want people to have some context about, you know, obviously you and I, we go way back. For people that don't know,
way back.
You know, you were handling some of my business stuff for me on the banking side years ago.
Yes.
But I knew back then, from the day I met you, real talk, that this dude right here, he's got it. You got the
man. Interview. That means so much to me. Thank you, man.
And that's real. Like, and people that know you, they know exactly what I'm talking about.
Thank you, brother.
They know. So, yeah, but I want to give people a little bit of context. So one of the things we talked about was obviously your other ventures, you know, obviously you got the stuff, you got the SOLA, and you got the perfumer. And then we're going to talk about the Zenith Year, because you got a lot coming up.
Yes, I have a lot coming up in 2020. So just like you said, I believe in, we've always talked about even the last episode, I believe in being multidimensional. I am in real estate. That is my 9-to-5. Yeah. I do own a fragrance collection. I have other partnerships and businesses that I dabble in as well. And then I'm writing a book for 2020 called The Zenith Year. So,
yeah. Okay. So you got to expand a little bit on this, because for some people, they may not have any idea about The Zenith Year. I love that. I love your idea. I love what you're thinking and the inspiration about it. So tell people a little bit more about The Zenith Year, and then what led you to even get to the point of thinking about coming up with this idea?
All right. That's great. Okay, that's a good segue. So the Zenith Year is all about planning for the best years of your life. Mm-hmm. Not the best year. Right. I think you can have a Zenith Year over and over and over again, but truthfully sitting down and planning your life out. I think a lot of people just kind of like live life by just every day by the coast.
Everybody's coasting, man.
Yeah, it's coasting. And I've been one of those people too. So the book is not here to judge anyone. It's really walking together on how we can reach our best selves, reach our zenith, reach our highest level, highest potential possible. And I came about that with really just everything that that from my fragrance line to the businesses that I put together, and I failed so much that I was constantly failing forward.
Yeah.
So this book is me going to be vulnerable in a sense about a lot of things that I've gone through, even things that I've gone through this year alone, but I believe in planning my life 2 years ahead of time. Now, here's the cool thing about, well, not really cool thing, but the stressful thing about the Zenith Year is life will throw you curveballs even when you're planning. So can you imagine not planning at all and getting thrown curveballs? So why not plan your year? Then when those curveballs come, you can adjust.
Yep.
You and I personally know at the beginning of this year, I was with a company and I got thrown a curveball, and I was able to adjust strategically and still not, you know, go through the hardest time. I went through hard times, but not the hardest times of my life. And it's just about being able to adjust and being able to understand that you can have the best years of your life if you understand the patterns that you take in your day-to-day life and plan for the future. Yeah. Reaching your and I'm walking through with my my consumers of the book, consumers of my platform. There's nobody here to judge. We're all in this thing called life together, and we are building our Zenith Year all together, step by step.
Yeah. So I do a lot of, you know, I've got a lot of mentors. I mean, Tony Robbins, Ed Milet, I got a lot of mentors that listen to their content. And so the Zenith, your mindset of planning it out to you. So I know Tony Robbins always talks about people underestimate what they can do. They overestimate what they can do in a year.
Right.
Estimate what they can do in 3 years, 5 years, 10 years. But the fact that, I mean, man, listen, I've been talking about this in my classes, in my fitness classes. The group fitness that okay, we're now in 2020, man. We got a few more decades.
Can you believe
the decade? The decade, right?
Mind so blown.
2020, and yeah, it's just like stuff, you know, things that you plan. I tell class, you remember 20 years ago when the world was gonna fall apart in 1999?
I know, right? And we were all waiting outside for the Y2K bug. Right. Remember that?
Exactly. Everybody was taking their money out the banks and like, not gonna work. And here we are 20 years ago. So I'll say all that just to say that 2 years is nothing, right?
Yes.
It's by.
Like so that.
Planning it out, and it is hard for people to think, even honestly, it's just hard. 2 years, again, it's nothing.
Yeah.
But it's still hard for people to think that far down the road. So what would you could kind of give I guess your take on the 2 year. Why not 12 months? Why not 6 months?
The reason I say is because I think 2 years is healthy because you're planning, but you're not looking for an end goal. The concept of the Zenith Year is there is no end goal.
Yeah.
Reaching your highest self means that you evolve daily and you rise year over year. It's like year over year numbers. I don't plan 12 months because 12 months, January, we were just talking, 12 months is here, you know? I'd rather plan for longevity. And I again, it's not, I guess maybe I'm kind of contradicting myself, but it's not an end goal. But like, I plan weekly, monthly, yearly. And then I have a goal that I want to reach. But then in reaching that goal, I have other things that I want that will kind of, when I reach that goal, make that goal be the thing that catapults me to my next strategy.
It's a step down for the next
setup. Like I'm setting myself up in steps, and it sounds crazy, and I don't know if I'm articulating it right, but
no, I'm with you. Yep.
I'm setting myself up. I have things I want to do in 5 years. So to answer your question, why would I plan something for 12 months if in 5 and 10 years I have a goal that I'm reaching? That I don't have an end goal. I don't believe in having an end goal.
Yeah,
but I have a goal that I want to reach. But I know that in order to reach that 10-year goal, I have to do things in 2 years to be strategic. So the 2 years, not saying I don't complete goals within 5, 6 months, 3 months or whatever, but I believe reaching your highest self is evolving and evolving daily, monthly, and sometimes a 1 year is not enough to reach your highest potential in whatever point of your life you want to be.
And I agree with you, by the way. I'm 2 year thing is
absolutely.
I think it's a great prime because again, it flies by so fast, man.
So fast. What is 2 years?
The part about it is again, you plan it for 2 years. It's hard for people to stay on course, right?
Yes.
And it really is. It's like the 1 foot in front of the other, man. These days just go by so fast.
So fast.
The 2 years is a great. I think that's a great. And then even within the 2 year, you know, you've got goals during
to get to that. Like,
absolutely.
I have monthly goals right now in different aspects of my life. I have monthly goals with my daughters. I have monthly goals in my career. I have monthly goals with my businesses.
Yeah.
And those monthly goals, and I think it's also healthy to set goals within goals because when you, even if it's a small goal and you reach it, you're like, I can do this. And that's all the Zenith Year is doing. It's like it's planning, but planning, purposeful planning, and reaching little goals in between that 2 year gap.
Yeah.
And I get it. Why 2 years? 2 years is just really what's worked for me. Let me keep it real. You know. And I can only translate to other people what I've actually done. I don't ever want to be one of these motivational speakers or people that are just preaching something that they've never achieved.
Two-year
planning is what I've actually done. I've talked about it multiple times, and it has worked for me.